Hi everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be doing my plan with me and this is for the week of August 19th through August 25th. And as they've been lately, this is going to be a memory spread. I have been very behind in my planning in my Erin Condren planner. So I've just been doing memory plans lately, which is basically going back in after the week has already finished and filling everything out. So for this week, I'm going to be using this really cute dinosaur kit. It's called Pretty Dinos. And this is from the shop Shepherd Supply Co. It's my first time using a kit from her shop, so I'm pretty excited to try out her format. And I specifically chose this kit for this week because the 20th was the first day of the new school year, and this kit just reminds me of the kiddos that I work with. I work at the elementary level from preschool through fifth grade, and so this is just really perfect. And the quote here says, "Be your own kind of beautiful," which is just so sweet and something that I hope for all my students. And really quickly, I'm going to go over what comes in the kit. Here we have, I believe, seven full boxes, a currently box, and then this little like clipboard checklist, and then we have three quarter boxes at the bottom. On this page, we have the date covers, we have a set of, I think, eight half boxes, some quarter boxes, get this done, you are amazing, which is so positive. We have two habit trackers and two build you stickers. And then on the next page here, we have all the headers and the little things. And I remember when I hauled this, I noticed that all of her headers, or at least these yellow ones on the side, were all really positive. So there's things like stay positive, you are enough, hey gorgeous, love yourself, you deserve it, things like that. So I just love that because it's such a great reminder and just like a positive message to start the new school year. On this page, we have three more of these like clipboard boxes. We've got a Monday through Sunday box. We have some check flags, some flags here, and then a bunch of text stickers with a weekend banner, which is so cute. It says "Hello Weekend." And I think we got two more pages, or last page actually. This is the bottom washi. I think it goes this way, maybe this way. Oh yeah, the bows are facing this way. So we have the bottom washi, which is two different strips, one with the floral and one with the bows, and some bow headers. And I think these are just pattern headers, this like yellow and white stripe pattern. And these are larger washi strips here. So it's a very full kit. I actually purchased this when she was having an anniversary sale, so it was like super affordable, maybe like $10 for the entire kit. So yeah, like I said, it's my first time trying out this format. I'm super excited because she has quite a lot of things that aren't always included in other kits, like these little clipboard boxes and like the positive headers that I had pointed out. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get started, and be sure to follow along if you wanna see how this turns out. I know it's been quite a while since I've uploaded a Plan With Me video, and I apologize for this little hiatus. Work has just been really, really busy. This is just kind of the time of the school year where everything kind of ramps up, and so I really just haven't had time and energy to work on videos. I actually recorded this like weeks ago, and so hopefully I kind of remember what I did. So the first thing I do with the bottom washi, instead of using the bow washi that came in the kit, I decided to pull in this washi that I had. It was a sample, and I believe it came from a Michaels roll, but I'm not 100% sure, and I don't know if they still have it, but it says adventure awaits, and I just thought that was so perfect to mark the beginning of the school year. I feel like every single school year is a whole new adventure, and I just really wanted to start it off with a positive note. And then I cut the floral washi a little bit so that it fit in the remaining space. Moving to my sidebar, I first whited out the large hexagon, and then I put down a full box where the old full box used to be on the Erin Condren. I pulled in this August script sticker that's from Heather B. Co., and she sent me a couple sheets of all of her like monthly lettering stickers, and I really, really love how they fit in that space. And then continuing with my sidebar, I used a glitter header from the kit, and then I used a habit tracker with a shoe sticker from Dizzy Daisy Dreams to mark my workout. I put down a strip of washi with a check flag to mark my happy moments, and then I used the dinners header from the kit with the Monday through Sunday box to track my dinners. And while I put down the date covers, I just want to mention that this video is going to be a leftovers giveaway. I've amassed quite a pile of leftover stickers over the last few months, and so yeah, if you would like to enter the giveaway for a chance to win these leftover stickers, and I'm also throwing in a bunch of extra stuff because I just had this like huge clean out sesh. But anyways, if you would like to enter, make sure you leave a comment down below that just says giveaway or a giveaway entry so I know that you would like to enter. More details will be in the description box below. I found these date covers that I thought matched the style of this kit pretty well, and those are from Ruby Trev, and then I move on to Monday. On Monday, I first put down one of those inspirational headers, and this one says, "You got this," and I thought that was a great way to start the week. And then I used a quarter box with a desk icon from Happy Dia stickers to mark that I had to finish organizing my office on that day. There was a ton of construction going on at my site, and they were supposed to finish sometime over the summer, but it definitely didn't get done. So things were still going on at the start of the school year, which was definitely hectic. And to mark that, I pulled in this little egg sticker, and that's from Hazel Sticker. I then decided to mark our staff luncheon on that day. The PTA was super kind and provided some really delicious food for our staff. And to mark that, I used a half box with a taco sticker from a Happy Blue Tree. I then placed down a full box and I pulled in this flag sticker, which I think is from my leftovers collection. I cut it down a little bit so that I could put it like more towards the center of the box. And I used a shopping girl sticker from Paper Bear Co. to mark that I went to Marshall's that day and got some stuff for my office. I then used an appointment label with this workout cat sticker. That's from a shop that's no longer open, and I use that to mark working out. And then that night we went over to my parents' house and we played some Mahjong, which is one of my favorite games, and so I used a Mahjong sticker from Hazel Sticker. I apologize for that rustling sound that you heard. My cat Pokey is in here with me while I'm recording, and she somehow managed to find a random plastic bag in the corner of the room. So yeah, she was all over that, but I've taken it away. So anyways, moving to Tuesday, first I put down a full box at the top, and then I used this You Are Enough header to kind of start the first day of school. And to mark the occasion, I put that on a half box, and the backpack sticker is from Simply Me Kish. The brush lettering pen that I'm using this week is from Zebra, and I believe it's in the extra fine size. I did get those at Daiso for only $1.50, so it was super affordable. But anyways, first I got coffee that morning, so I used a coffee sticker from Sweet Ava's Paper, and then we had a staff meeting that afternoon, and to mark that, I put that on a quarter box with a pencil sticker from Nikki Plus 3. I then went to happy hour with some of my coworkers. The happy hour sticker is from Paper and Milk, and then the beer sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. It was really fun getting together with them. I think this was the first time we've gotten together, even though we've known each other for like almost 5 years now. So it was really fun to like get to see them outside of school. And when I got home, I just kind of had a lazy night, and I used a flag to mark that. On Wednesday, I first put down a full box at the bottom, and then I moved to the top and really quickly just placed down a header, and that one says My Amazing Day. Moving back to the center, I put down a clipboard sticker because I knew I had lots of things to mark and probably not enough space to mark them all separately. And then I moved back to the top. I ended up deciding to remove the header sticker, and I pulled in a quarter box instead with this annoyed emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. to mark that I had lost my microwave that day. It actually just disappeared out of my office, so I don't know what happened to it, and I tried asking for it back, but of course nobody admitted to having it, so I currently no longer have a microwave. I then did some more organizing of my office space, so I put down that flat lay sticker, and I believe that's from Hazel Sticker. I didn't like the way I wrote organize, or I think it might have been because I had whited out underneath that, so my writing was a bit uneven, and so I ended up rewriting it on, I think, like a Bill Do sticker, and then I cut it out because that inside part was white, and I think that worked out really nicely. On the checklist, I just put down the things that I did that day, and one of the things I did was cook, and so I pulled in this Cooking Girl sticker from Happy Dia Stickers. On my sidebar, I decided to use this important script sticker just to mark my happy moments, and because I just really like that text sticker that came in the kit, and then I moved to Thursday. So the first thing on Thursday is I marked my sister's birthday. The cake sticker I think is from Simply Me Kish, and then again I used my Zebra brush lettering pen to do brush lettering, and then underneath that I put down a flag with a car sticker from Nicole Hutch Designs to mark that I had to grab something from the district office that day, and while I was out doing that I decided to pick up some Del Taco for lunch. The taco sticker is from Plans with Finesse, and then underneath that I put down a full box. I had a meeting afterwards, and so I used an appointment label to mark that, and then at the very bottom I put down a You Are Amazing header and cut up a circle checklist into three to-do items and just wrote down the things that I did that day when I got home from work. On Friday, I first started by putting down a full box at the top, and then I really wanted to pull in this Friday Best Day Ever text sticker from the kit, so I put that on top of the full box, and then I used a half box to mark that Taylor Swift's Lover album came out that day. I was so, so in love with it. It's so good, and I still like have it on repeat almost every single day. The girl holding the heart sticker, I actually don't know where that's from because it was in my leftover stash, but I just thought that was so perfect to mark the Lover album. And then underneath that, initially I pulled in this coffee sticker, I think it's from Peanut Butter Taco, to mark my coffee, but I realized that it took up a bit too much space, so I used a little thing to mark that instead. The new coffee sticker I pulled in is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams, and then to mark a staff meeting that morning, I used a pencil sticker, and I believe that is from Little Star Plans. I then kind of worked backwards, so at the end of the night, I put down a quarter box with a Mahjong sticker, again from Hazel Sticker, to mark that we played more Mahjong at my parents' house, and then we had homemade Korean barbecue that night with my parents, and that was a really fun experience, and so I pulled in this Korean barbecue sticker, which is also from Hazel Sticker. I had just a sliver of space remaining, so I decided to mark that we had to pick up some groceries before we did Korean barbecue. So I used one of those patterned headers from the kit, and the grocery icon is from Sunset Sticker Co., which I don't think is open anymore. On Saturday, I first put down a full box at the bottom, and then I really wanted to use this weekend banner because I think it's so cute, but I knew I wouldn't have enough space to fit it during the day, so I decided to lift up the date covers on Saturday and Sunday and place the weekend banner right there on the top. On Saturday, I first put down this yellow header, and this one I think says, "You deserve it," and I think I was just marking like a little bit of self-care time in the morning where I had time to paint my nails, and the nail polish sticker is from Lemon Paper Co., which also is no longer open. We then attended a baby shower for some of our friends, and I don't have any baby-related stickers, so I decided to pull in this really cute plant, kind of like a sprout from Dizzy Daisy Dreams, because I feel like, you know, it's kind of the same idea of like a new life, but that was like the closest thing I had. I then decided to put down all of the functional boxes that I was going to be using. So I used a flag, a washi strip, and a half box. So with the flag, I used this Beer Girl sticker from Paper Bear Co. to mark that we, after the baby shower, we went and grabbed some beers with some of our friends who were passing through town. And then on the washi strip, I just marked that we stopped by the liquor store before we headed to a friend's birthday party that night. We wanted to grab him some beer as a birthday present. And to mark the birthday party, I pulled in these banner stickers, and I think that's from L May Plans. Moving to Sunday, I first used a half box at the top, and this adorable sloth sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. I used that to mark that I was moving a bit slow on Sunday, and then I used a quarter box with a YouTube icon from Paper and Milk to mark that I did some filming that morning. I then used a washi strip with the Lazy Day script sticker from the kit to mark that Sunday was just a pretty lazy day for us. We didn't really do anything. And then I used the last full box, which says currently, and I put in this Boba Time sticker inside. I think that's from L May Plans as well, which is no longer open, unfortunately. Underneath that, I used a Little Things to mark my dinner. And then at the end of the night, my boyfriend and I started this show called Fleabag. And you guys have probably heard it by now because it won a bunch of Emmys like a few weeks ago. And it's just like the most amazing show ever. I mean, it's like funny and it's sad and it's sweet and it's, you know, heartbreaking all at the same time. And it's just so well done. So if you guys haven't seen it, it's on Amazon Prime. I highly recommend it. Although I will say it's pretty vulgar and raunchy, so you kind of have to be prepared or okay with that. But anyways, it's amazing. So highly recommend. That TV sticker is from Happy Dia Stickers. And I thought that was so cute with the two little cats watching TV together. That is it for the week, so now I'm just going back and filling in my workouts, my happy moments, and my dinners. And then once I'm done with that, I go ahead and show you guys these stickers that I have left in this kit, which will be included in this leftovers giveaway. So yeah, like I said earlier, if you're interested in entering this giveaway, make sure you leave a comment down below that says giveaway, just so I know that your comment is an entry. And yeah, that is it for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed this. This was such a fun, special week because I feel like the first week of the school year is always like so much fun. And then it might just kind of go downhill from there. But, you know, at least we kind of start off on a really positive note. And if there's anything I forgot to mention, just let me know in the comments and I'll definitely get back to you. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. And I also hope you guys have a wonderful week. And yeah, I will talk to you next time. Bye.